Jacob here with Sarracenia Northwest, and this is your Carnivorous Plant Care Guide for September 2024. At the start of September, the sun is noticeably lower in the sky, giving you the sense that fall is just around the corner. Now, we can still get a blast of summer weather early in the month, but as we move into the latter parts of September, the days are mostly sunny and mild with very cool nights. Sarracenia leucophylla and alata produce some amazing pictures in September, a stark contrast to their pictures from a few months ago. You can see that their late season pictures are taller and more colorful. The effect is quite dramatic on cultivars like Chanel's Ghost and Orthus. Many hybrids are also putting on a show, producing their best pictures of the season right now. On the flip side, Sarracenia flava produce non-carnivorous leaves called phyllodia. Oreophylla and its hybrids are also getting ready to drop their pitchers. These species are on a different cycle and produce their best pitchers early in the season. They also go dormant much earlier than others. Venus flytraps also grow larger traps during September. We have many varieties that are putting on a show right now. Traps produced in September will last through the winter. However, the traps produced in early summer will die off as the days get shorter and colder. Hardy sundews are starting to go dormant. Once we get past the fall equinox, they will be completely dormant. To care for your outdoor perennials, first, make sure they're getting lots of sunlight and water. Sunlight and water are still important for these plants, even if they're about to go dormant. With your late season Sarracenia, you can also spruce them up by clipping off the early season pitchers. This will bring more focus to the late season pitchers. Now, if you're unsure about which pitchers to cut off, just follow this basic rule. If you can't stand looking at it, cut it off. You can also leave the plant as it is. There is no harm in keeping the older pitchers, nor is there any harm in trimming them off. It's all a matter of personal taste. With our tropical greenhouse, we plan to remove the shade cloth later in the month when the weather cools a bit more. Now, while we're on the topic of tropical plants, if you moved any tropical plants outdoors for the summer, pay attention to the nighttime temperatures. Most tropical plants can withstand a quick overnight dip down to about 40 degrees Fahrenheit. But you should move your tropical plants back inside when temperatures consistently drop to about the low 50s or upper 40s. If in doubt, just bring them inside. It's best to be safe than sorry. But before bringing your plants back inside, spray them with a pesticide. You want to make sure you kill off any pests that might be on your plants. I recommend using neem oil because it's organic and safe to use around pets and humans. Just make sure to use it as directed by the manufacturer. In September, many tropical plants will perk up now that we're past the intense heat of summer. Many tropical butterworts and sundews grow best when the weather is mild and bright. Nepenthes also appreciate the mild temperatures of September. This is when you'll see a flush of new pitchers and a spurt in growth that would continue into November. With all of your tropical plants, make sure they're still getting the appropriate sunlight and water. Now, if you need help with your carnivorous plants, we're here for you. Visit our website, growcarnivorousplants.com, and look for the Ask the Growers link. Fill out the form about your plant, and one of our growers will get back to you shortly. And while you're on our website, check out the latest inventory update. We got many plants ready for new homes, and we have a couple of great specials going on right now. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in another video.